Hello, this is Bob Swanson, ICC Astronomy Instructor. I'm going to help you work through the Module 11 lab activity. This deals with the cosmic distance ladder. And I'm actually going to approach this a little differently than some of the videos I've made in the past. I'm actually going to help to try to step you through the student guide a little more step-by-step than I have than a lot of the more generic or general videos I've made in the past. So obviously when you click into Module 11, you're going to come to this lab activity page. Again, here's where you print your student guide. I recommend you print this off in order to follow along with the video, or at least have it open up in a separate screen. And then of course you're going to click this to actually get to the lab itself. And so when you click on this link, it's going to take you to this page. Now notice with this cosmic distance ladder, there's a lot of stuff. There's a lot of content here. And I'm actually going to show you the summation first. Sometimes you're going to click through here and not even get to the summation. This one actually is important because it's going to help guide us as to, you know, why are we doing this. And so this is what you see when you click on the summation. And really the whole point of this lab is to help you to appreciate that it's very difficult to find out distances in space. And you might be curious as to know, you know, when we talk about a particular star being, or a particular galaxy being, you know, 2 million light years away, how do we know? How do we know that a certain star is a certain number of light years away? And it all has to do with these different techniques of gauging distance in space. Are they absolutely 100% accurate? No. There's a lot of uncertainty with some of the techniques, but it's the best we have. And so for close stuff, stuff that's in our solar system, as we're going to learn, radar ranging is the main technique. Outside of our solar system, within our galaxy, parallax becomes a bigger player. And then as we get farther out, greater distances in our own galaxy, we have to use things like main sequence fitting or spectroscopic parallax. When we get even farther out, we get into cluster fitting. And then even farther out, we get into supernovae line curve fitting. And these are the ways that we discover the distances to these objects that are farther and farther and farther away. And of course, with greater distance comes greater uncertainty. But it's very, to me, very amazing that physicists have figured out how to tease out this kind of information by using generally basic laws of physics and very little amount of data. You know, again, with astronomy, the ultimate, the really cool thing is that you're getting a lot of information from very little data. We don't have that much light coming into our telescopes, and yet we're able to tease out a lot of information. So anyway, going back into these background pages, again, start with the one about radar ranging. This will describe the process of radar ranging. And of course, like I said, this is how we figure out the distance to close things, such as the moon. In fact, Apollo 11 astronauts put a mirror on the moon, and what we do is we shoot pulses up to that mirror and reflect those pulses, and then we figure out the distance. So for close stuff, you can use the process of radar ranging. A little bit farther out, you use a process called parallax, which has to do with the fact that close stars or close objects will show a shift amongst the background stars during the course of one Earth orbit. When we're on this side of the sun and we look at a particular star, it's going to look like it's in a certain position with respect to the background stars. When we 6 months later get to the other side of the sun and look at that same star or that same object, it will have appeared to have changed its position with respect to those background stars because it is closer to us than those background stars that we essentially assume to be stationary. And so you can play around with the Parallax Explorer. There's a couple of presets, and you know what you can do is they tell you to take a measurement, and so you take a measurement and you move your and you do a bunch of overlaps and determine how far away that sailboat is that you're looking at out on the lake. That's preset B. And preset C, you're going to notice that your where you can take measurements is limited. They limit to how far along the baseline you can move. And that's going to affect the accuracy of your measurement. So that's the parallax method. Again, moving on to larger and larger distances, you get into what's called the distance modulus. And this is actually page 3 in your student guide. And this, again, looks like it's kind of complex math. Don't let the complex math intimidate you. The first row on page 3 in that data table asks to find out the absolute magnitude and distance modulus to this particular star A, that has an apparent magnitude of 2.4 and a distance of 10. Well, anything that has a distance of 10 parsecs is going to have a distance modulus, or a little m minus big M, of 0. And so if I put in 10 here, sure enough, my m minus little m minus big M is 0. Well, the only way I can have a little m of 2.4 minus a big M to equal 0 is if my big M is also 2.4. So that's how you fill out that first row. The second row, we want an object that is 16 parsecs away to have an absolute magnitude of 5. So I'm going to change this to be 16. My distance is 16. And notice that my little m minus big M has to be 1.02. And therefore, in order to have little m minus 5 give me 1.02, my little m's got to be 6.02. And that's what you would fill in for that table. So that's the way that works. Okay, so that'll help you get through the distance modulus part. And I realize I'm getting a little long here, so I'm going to break this video up into a couple of parts. So this is part one. We'll end it here at the distance modulus, and I'll come back with part two to describe how to move on to the spectroscopic parallax.